Hey guys, currently we are looking at the Maruti 800 engine. So this is the model number is F8BMPFI, and this model is for 3-cylinder engines, and the displacement volume is 796 cc. And currently we are opening the engine plate of the car plate of the engine. You see a knob here which is for like pouring in the lubrication oil, and which sums down into the some below the pistons. So like we are looking now at the head of the engine. So this head has spark plugs here, and then rocker mechanism for the working of the valves, and like the valves control the intake and exhaust of the fresh air and the combusted air respectively. Now we are looking at the timing belt of the engine. So this is basically the cover of the timing belt, and it prevents various parts to like get engaged with the timing belt and damage it. So this covering is used for that purpose. And now we are now having a look at the gear for the timing belt. And there are two gears for the timing belt, and the timing belt is runs over them. These two gears are can be manually fasten and to set the timing. You see a hole here, the fastener is fastened here. So this is used for transmission of power from engine crankshaft to the rocker mechanism. And so this is the belt is removed here, and then we are disengaging the gear also, and the lower gear again. Then we are disengaging it, and we're removing the car plate now. So now we are having a look at, we are removing the exhaust system now. So this is the exhaust manifold, and then we remove the exhaust gasket. So you see three exhaust passages here, because it's a 3-cylinder engine. And then we have a look at the intake system here, and this also has three openings because we have 3-cylinder engines, and these have been designed specifically to meet the requirement of the flow of gases. And then we switch to removing the head to look to have a insight into the engine. So we use a T spanner to do so, because a simple spanner cannot go inside here in these bolts, because they are deep into a little between the parts. So a simple spanner cannot go there. And the engine head is fitted in a way that it is quite difficult to remove it, and so we require a mechanical advantage for the same purpose. We use some screwdriver sort of thing and remove the head. So as we remove the head, we see the internal mechanisms of an engine, which obviously are the pistons. You see this, the piston is here, so there you see the head of the piston, and then you see these are the valves. This is the inlet valve, exhaust valve, and this is the spark plug here. So the spark plug basically ignites at the end of the compression stroke. So you see these grooves. These grooves are basically for this is a spark plug here, the rocker here, and the grooves, as which I was mentioning here. You see, this is the alternator, which is used for generating electricity inside the car, which is required for various purposes. Which the initial step being the so this is the oil filter for the lubrication oil, and we put back the head here. So as I was telling you about the alternator, so alternator is used to charge the low voltage battery, which does the cranking job also while we are trying to start the car. And this also has got a voltage regulator, which basically keeps a check for the over voltage of the battery, and avoid that scenario basically. And the oil filter, you see the orange part here, is used to filter the lubrication oil, and which lies in the sump, which is just below this crankshaft and cylinder. And we fasten the engine head back again here, and for the you put back this exhaust valve. The exhaust valves are specifically designed to so as to create a low pressure region while the flow is the exhaust is from one cylinder. In that case, like it generates a vacuum and enhance the inflow of the fresh air also inside the piston, and then we so the timing gears have got a slot and where a key can be put in so that this can remove. So this is the component which is used to power the water pump, basically, which is used for the cooling of engine. So in the engine is liquid cooled, and we place the car plate back here so as to protect our timing belt, and as we place back our engine cover plate. So this has been collectively done by Sahil, Abhishek, and